So let's do a problem on the Clausius Clapeyron equation. Calculate the boiling point of water under a pressure of 280 mm. That's the question. Given the boiling point of water under a pressure of 180 mm is 373.2 Kelvin, and the latent heat of vaporization of water is 539 kJ per gram. Specific volume of water is 1 cc and that of steam is 1674 cc. Okay. So we can see, we have seen the Clausius Clapeyron equation as dP over dT, that's equal to, either I can write as delta S upon delta V, okay, so where delta S is the change in the specific entropy of the system and delta V is the change in the specific volume of the system between the two phases concerned. But since here you are given the latent heat, means I have to use the dP by dT equation in terms of the latent heat, you know, that is given by L divided by T into, for delta S we substitute L by T into delta V, and delta V is V final minus V initial. Okay, so now let's take all the values here. So let's see, you are given the boiling point of water under the pressure of 180 mm. So the pressure when it is P initial, when it is 180 mm, then the boiling point, that is TBP, the boiling point is equal to 373.2 Kelvin. That is what is given. Now we have to find out the boiling point, what be T boiling point dash, we call it, when the pressure is changed to 280 mm. So this is a question. Whenever the pressure is changed from 180 mm to 280 mm, what will be the new boiling point? Okay, so you are given the latent heat of vaporization of water. So L vaporization, that is equal to 539 calories per gram. 539 calories per gram. So let's convert it into SI units. So that is 539 into, you know, 1 calorie is equal to 4200. Okay, so 4200. Okay, you can just convert this one joule per kilogram. So I have converted into joule per kilogram, that is there. Now other things, what is given? Specific volume of water. So V is equal to, we can say V initial is equal to, see, V initial is equal to 1 cc. Cc means cubic centimeter, centimeter cube. So actually it should be per gram, 1 cc per gram, that's what they mean. So that would be equal to 1 cc. What is 1 cc equal to? That would be equal to I can say centimeter cube, no? So centimeter cube means convert to minus, raised to minus 2 whole cubed, right? So I'm just now converting into meter cube, divided by gram should be converted into kilogram. So it is what, 10 raised to minus 3, right? Okay, so finally this much I can say meter cube per kilogram. Okay, so how much is that one? That will be equal to 10 raised to minus 6 by 10 raised to minus 3. So that will be equal to 10 raised to simply 10 raised to minus 3, right? Finally that is 10 raised to minus 3 meter cube per kilogram. That will be the SI unit. Similarly, V final is equal to, what is given for the vapor? It is 1674 cc. The same manner I can write this one is equal to what is that one? It will be equal to 1674 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube per kilogram. That's the specific volume of the vapor. So you know, it is water is converted into vapor, liquid water is converted into vapor. So what is the relevant thing? That is the latent heat of vaporization is the so liquid water is converted to vapor, latent heat of vaporization. So here I'll be just modify the equation. See here, L means L of vaporization, we had three different kinds of equation, and here the corresponding thing is the boiling point, T boiling point. Now you have to find out, one more thing, see, here what is dp? From this one you will get dp from this one. So dp is equal to, moreover, we write that dp is equal to 2 minus 1, so that is equal to 1 atm. And you know, atm is not an SI unit, which you have to convert it into the corresponding SI unit, which is Pascal. So that is equal to 1.013, that we have learned, into 10^5 Pascal, right? That is a conversion factor for atm to Pascal. Even though it is not given, see that you are supposed to just do the conversion there. Now let me rewrite this equation, equation number one. So I need dt, right? The change in boiling point. So dt is needed. So let me rewrite this equation as dt is equal to dp times dp into tbp, right? I'm just cross multiplying and write tbp into vf minus v initial divided by l vaporization. So you can just make the substitution now. All the quantities are given here. So that is dp is 1.013 into 013, or 1 into, that is enough, roughly 10^5 times the T boiling point, that is given to be 373.2 Kelvin, that is okay, into Vf minus Vi. So it will be 1674 minus 1, okay, the power is into 10^-3 whole divided by L vaporization, that is how much, it's given to be 539 into 4200. So we write it like as such, 539 into 4200. Yes, all are in SI units. Just you do the calculation, you will be getting it as 27. Just check it, 27.5, and the unit will be Kelvin. So you obtain that due to the increase in the pressure. So when the pressure is increased from 1 atm to 2 atm, there will be a corresponding change in the temperature dt, which is equal to 27.5 Kelvin. What does it mean? That means that the new boiling point, so you know that due to when pressure is increased, the boiling point also will be getting increased. New boiling point, okay, and what we have called, it is a tbp dash is equal to, what should be that? It will be equal to TBP, which is the original boiling point, plus what? DT. So that will be equal to 373.2 plus what? 27.5. So that's equal to finally something around some 400, okay, 0.7, right? 400.7 Kelvin. So that is the answer. And this is exactly an application of the Clausius Club period equation. So what we are seeing is this one: as you increase the pressure, dp is increased, you can see that the dt will be there, and this dt will result in an increase in the boiling point. And that's one thing, and that is why in a previous session I told you that at Everest, okay, where the pressure is not getting increased, instead the pressure is getting reduced, you can see the boiling point of water also will be getting what? Reduced. And it's not only applicable for water, it's applicable for any system where the temperatures will be depending on pressure, the ambient pressure. And that is the one of the applications of the Clausius Clapeyron equations. So you can just refer to more problems of this kind, which includes some kind of boiling point or melting point and all, and how it varies with the change in pressure. Okay, thank you.